Good morning. My name is Suthida Chai Chom Chun. The topic of my presentation is an adaptive activity system for online learning based on knowledge management process for a technical education curriculum at KMUTNB. Please let me introduce myself. I am a lecturer at Department of Computer Education in Faculty of Technical Education of King Mongkut University of Technology, North Bangkok, Thailand. I will start my talk with one introduction, and I will go over to methodology, three results, and four conclusions. Let's start with the introduction. The Faculty of Technical Education at the King Mongkut University of Technology, North Bangkok, also known as KMUTNB, has mission to produce and develop qualified technical teachers. The university offers the degrees in bachelor's, master, and doctoral levels. There are four programs offered in undergraduate level, which are mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, civil engineering, and computer technology. Every student required to take both technical courses and educational courses. By the way, all programs share some educational courses in common. Educational courses aim to develop professional teaching competencies such as course development, understanding classroom dynamics, class management, etc. Therefore, all program will share some educational courses in common. By the way, every program will run their own educational classes by their own lecturers. Because the classes are run by lecturers from different programs, hence different departments. Therefore, each department may run the class by using different types of teaching methods. Lecturers from student departments will actually run the class differently. Also, different experience and different teaching skill of lecturer may result in different student perceptions. Despite the difference in lecturer teaching methods, students are also different. Considering how the student learns, there are two factors that make students different: learning styles and intelligences. A learning style is an individual natural or habitual pattern of acquiring and processing information in learning situations. Gratian and Lisman introduced six types of learning style that they developed. The six types of learning styles are an independent, avoidance, collaborative, dependent, competitive, and participative. All six types of learning style come from student thinking process and how students participate with others in class. If lecturer know how the student learn in the class, they will be able to adapt learning activities to fit the students. This will help optimize students to learn and develop their knowledge in the class accordingly. The second main factor is an individual intelligence. It is an ability to solve problems in a different environment or other creative work. The ability to find solutions to problems in order to increase knowledge. Howard Gardner has categorized an individual intelligence into 8 categories as follows: 1. Linguistic, 2. Logical mathematical, 3. Visual spatial, 4. Bodily kinesthetic, 5. Musical, 6. Interpersonal, 7. Intrapersonal, and 8. Naturalist. Gardner believes that each person normally has more than one type of intelligence. They would use their multiple intelligence to express their personal character. The intelligence can be, according to aforementioned differences, is this a challenge? How can we match the teaching methods of the teacher with the learning style and intelligence of the student? In this study, we use the LMS as a tool to manage learning environment. LMS stands for Learning Management System. Alice has explained that it is a software application for the administration, documentation, tracking, reporting, and delivery of e-learning education courses or training programs. Moodle has been selected to use as an LMS for this study. Since an LMS provides us with only tools to manage a learning environment, it is our task how to analyze the difference of students. We have developed a new module called an Intelligent Turing System, or ITS, which applies a theory of artificial intelligence in order to provide different students with different learning environments to study. From the definition, the ITS is an online learning system which presented the learning content to the student systematically, monitors the student performance, and personalized instruction to suit the student learning style and knowledge level. From now on, the role of the teacher is now changed to be a facilitator. Our study has also applied knowledge management to the learning environment, which will change a teacher to be a facilitator, who is responsible for matching students with appropriate content and learning activities. Therefore, our research concept can be explained by the diagram here. We start with the study of the difference of students in both learning style and their multiple intelligences. After that, all the learning activities will be arranged and provided to the LMS, which is applied the dynamic learning environment from the ITS, and use the KM to manage the knowledge of teachers and students systematically. From what I have talked so far, therefore, we have four objectives for this research. 1. To analyze the learning style and intelligences of the students in technical education fields at KMUTNB. 2. To design online learning activities for the students. 3. To design and develop an e-learning adaptive activity system on the Moodle learning tools. 4. To evaluate the system by the experts. Let's go over the methodology. The methodology for this research is shown here on this slide. Starting from 1. Find the learning style and intelligences of the students. 2. Design online learning activities. 3. Design and develop an adaptive activity system. And the last one, the system will be varied by the experts. The first step. Finding the learning styles and intelligences of the students. 1. Sample of this study is 719 undergrad students from 4 different programs in Faculty of Technical Education at KMUTNB. 2. Develop 2 questionnaires to gather student learning styles and their multiple intelligences. 3. Collect the data. 4. Analyze the data using standard descriptive statistics such as frequency and percentage. 5. Categorize the top 3 learning styles and multiple intelligence. Here are the top 3 learning styles and intelligences. The top 3 learning styles are collaborative, participative, and dependent. The top 3 intelligences are bodily kinesthetic, interpersonal, and naturalist. We use the McKenzie method to regroup the 3 intelligences into 2 groups. The bodily and kinesthetic and interpersonal will be grouped into an interactive type, while the naturalist is equivalent to the analytic type of McKenzie. We call them in terms of many-to-many like this. There will be 6 groups of a combination between learning styles and intelligence as shown on this picture. The second step is designing online activities for the groups. The following three criteria are considered. 1. Activities according to learning styles. 2. Activity according to multiple intelligences. And 3. Activity according to the tools provided by the LMS. All three criteria are branded in order to design different activities that fit each different student groups. Here are the activities according to the three different learning styles. 1. For the collaborative learning style, students is divided into a group of 4 to 6 persons. Teacher will encourage them to collaboratively work together. 2. For the participative learning style, students learn together in class. They are encouraged to choose their own contents. Participation is required for this type of learning style. Teacher usually keeps track of student participation and activity as well. 3. For the dependent learning style, students from a group of 2 to 3 persons. Students with different academic backgrounds will be branded in each group. Students with good academic background usually encourage the less in the group, while teacher will evaluate the group periodically. Here are the activities according to the two intelligence groups. 1. For the interactive group, there are 4 activities for this group, which are discussion, questioning, acquisition, and case study. This group focuses on activities that enable them to communicate with members in the group, as well as how to convey information to others. 2. For the analytic group, there are also 4 activities for this group, which are simulation, practice, acquisition, and case study. This group focuses on the process of analysis. From the previous slides, we have all 6 activities based on the 2 intelligence groups. Now, we match all 6 activities with the module provided by the Moodle, the LMS that we use in this study. From the T criteria, we use to design online activities for student groups. We can now arrange the activities for each group as shown in the picture here. Step 3 is to design and develop an adaptive activity system. This step divides into 2 parts as follows. 3.1, design an adaptive activity system model, which is a combination of 2 things, an adaptive activity system and a knowledge management process. An adaptive activity system model derived from an analysis of the ITS model. And finally, we have the system that composes of 6 modules, which are 1. Interface module. This is to control the communication between the users and the system, which include the students group and teachers group. 2. Instructor module. This is to manage the information of the teachers, to correct the data, create the contents and various activities of the teachers in a subject course. T. Domain module. This is to collect the knowledge base in the system, which includes contents, knowledge resources, activities, exercise, or the tests of various subjects, which will be applied for learning activities. These knowledge base are created by the teachers. 4. Student module. This is to manage the information of the student and send this information to the expert module to make a decision of learning activities appropriate to each student. 5. Expert module. This is to analyze the data of student got by the student module and select the activities appropriate to each student. 6. Learning activities module. This is to perform the learning activity according to the expert module selected to the student by eliciting the knowledge base from domain module to present. The main components of expert module can be divided into 2 parts as follows. 1. Learning style module. This is the part used for analyzing the learning style of the students. After making the measurement test of learning styles, and bringing the scorecard to evaluate which the group they are in, and derive the data to be kept in the student module. 2. Multiple intelligence module. This is the part used for analyzing the student intelligence after doing the multiple intelligence measurement test and evaluating the score to categorize into groups, and derive the data to be kept in the student module. Expert module will investigate the learning style and multiple intelligence value of the students, which the activity match and derive the data to the learning activity module to present the learning activity to the students at the first step. The students can do the activities according to system selection or do other activities existing in the system according to their requirement. Next is the knowledge management. We have applied the process from the Office of the Public Sector Development Commission and Thailand Productivity Institute, which has 7 steps as follows. Knowledge identification, knowledge creation and acquisition, knowledge organization, knowledge codification and refinement, knowledge access, knowledge sharing, and learning. The process starts from the very first step to the very last step, and then loop back to start it all over again. Then we combine two parts into one, which become an adaptive activity system based on KM process model, as shown in the picture. From the picture, we can see that teachers involved with the first two steps, knowledge identification and knowledge creation and acquisition, which are grouped into instructor module. Then the system will go on with domain module, which composes of the steps of the knowledge organization and knowledge codification and refinement. Here, teacher will be responsible for the refinement. Next, student will access the knowledge with the decision from the expert module. Knowledge will convey to the student through the learning activity module. Student will share their knowledge in this step. While teacher will serve as a guide to the student learning. Learning will take place here, and students gain the knowledge for their future. 3.2. Develop an adaptive activity system. From the previous step, we now have the model. Then, we develop the system using the ADDIE, which has 5 steps as follows: analyze, design, develop, implement, and evaluate. In the analysis step, we 1. Study the function of Moodle. 2. Analyze the functions of the system. 3. Analyze the activities of the users. For the design step, we will start from 1. Design 4 additional parts on Moodle, which are learning style of the student part, multiple intelligence of the student part, adaptive learning activity part, and learning competency part. 2. Design database schema, and 3. Design user interaction. And what we do in the development step are 1. Develop the learning style test. 2. Develop the multiple intelligence test. 3. Create the database tables. And 4. Create module which put students into groups and suggest the learning activities that match their learning style and intelligences. Next step is the implementation, and we start from 1. Install the adaptive activity system on the server. 2. The system testing. And 3. Improve and adjust the system. Once the development of the system is done, the system needs to be tested by the experts, which go through the following steps. First step, sample. Sample is 6 experts in the field of education and technology. Over 5 years of teaching experience, having at least a master's degree. Second step, data collection. Create system evaluation test and evaluate the system in 5 aspects. The last step, analysis. Statistical analysis, using a mean and a standard deviation. Here is the result of this study. 1. We have categorized the student in the Faculty of Technical Education at KMUTNB into 6 groups based on the learning style and their multiple intelligence as shown in the picture. 2. We have arranged the learning activities for each group in accordance with the tools provided by Moodle. Each group has 4 different activities. 3. The system we have developed. This system called Crucial Knowledge Management, using the Moodle as an LMS. The system works on an internet browser. The system starts with launching two questionnaires to correct student learning style and their intelligence before they can go further. This is the teacher part for managing contents in the system. Sample questionnaires that students need to take before entering the system. When students finish answering questions in the questionnaires, the system will match the learning activities that fit the students on the top of this page. Any activities not related to learning will be listed below. This is the effectiveness of the system in 5 categories, which evaluated by 6 experts in the field of education and technology. We can see that all 5 categories have been evaluated at a good level. Here is the conclusion of this study. In conclusion, the adaptive activity system based on the concept of student learning style, multiple intelligence, intelligent learning system, modern, and non-management can be effectively used to teach educational course for technical education students because it can intelligently choose appropriate learning activity that suits student learning style and intelligence.This system prioritizes the learning activity that match the student learning style and intelligence, because this activity can help students learn the best. However, this system still allows students to do other activity provided, even though this activity do not correspond to their learning style. Thank you for your attention.